Got the whole ensemble there, my man. First of all, this is not fair. It's, here it is. You got breakfast laid out, and you're probably in Chi-Town, and I'm nowhere near there. Don't put it all out there, and then you can't share with nobody. Don't say it's all in the book, and you make it. I don't want to hear that, man. First of all, how you doing, Dr. Ian?
I'm good, man. Life is good. Life is really good.
Before you say all that, how are you dealing with all this coronavirus stuff, bro?
Oh, man, I'm thriving.
You're thriving? How? Oh. You're the only one.
I'm writing like crazy. I'm lifting weights in my basement like crazy. I'm playing tennis with my kids like crazy. I'm creating recipes, having fun, watching Netflix. Listen, my attitude is find the silver lining in the cloud. There's nothing I can do about a global pandemic. I got to shelter in place like everybody else. I got to be careful. But listen, if I'm going to be stuck at home and not with you guys, I might as well get some stuff done. I'm being productive, man.
Thanks for making this all positive. I appreciate that. Look, here's the deal. Obviously, you have a brand new book, Mind Over Weight. Let's talk about it a little bit. And I see you got the breakfast all laid out there. So I'm still upset with you about that, but let's talk about it anyway.
Hannah, this is a book I've been wanting to write for a long time. You have been looking at some of my books. This is number 18 from it. But Mind Over Weight really is all about getting your mind in the right space. Listen, when you talk about why people are not successful at weight loss, one of the most common reasons is motivation. Lack of motivation, being able to find motivation. This book talks about what you need to do above your neck in order to stay in the game and win the game. Listen, yeah. I don't care how many great diet plans you follow, how many great trainers you may have or exercise plans. If your mind isn't right, you are not going to find the level of success you want. So I've been wanting to write this book for a long time. It's a small book. Look how small it is. It's a really small book. I wrote it that way. It's just 7 chapters. At the end of each chapter is an action plan. And it's really built to get people in that right mind frame to do what they need to do.
Now, what's the layout with the food all about, bro?
Yeah, so these are some items that I like to talk about. You know, we're all sheltered in place. And so either we can't get to grocery stores like we want to, or grocery stores don't have everything we want. So these are just some basics. So maybe I'll take you through a couple of them if you want.
Yeah, let's do it. Let's do it.
Yeah, so everyone has beans at home, or they can buy beans. Those are not, you know, in short supply. So I decided to use some black beans and some brown rice, which is also easy to find. And I made a nice beans and rice dish. It has some syrup, a little maple syrup in it, and it has a little cumin and a little chili powder. So lots of fiber and lots of protein. I love pasta, but I tell people go for the whole grain pasta. Whole grain pasta is not as processed as white pasta, and you still have the benefits of the whole grain. So here I have some whole grain pasta. I use some chicken. If you have chicken, you can use some grilled chicken or use some beans for protein. Okay. And then I quartered some zucchini, some squash, a light cream sauce, and voila, you have your pasta.
All right. Now, I'm kind of concerned. I like the black beans and brown rice, but is that a little carb heavy for me or not? Can I get away with this? Now, I'll be honest with you, that's what I ate yesterday, but I felt guilty.
No, don't feel guilty. These are good carbs, right? The bad carbs are like cakes and cookies. I say bad. The carbs that aren't great for you are the cookies, the cakes, the pastries. We have to have carbs. In fact, at least 35 to 40% of your calories should come from carbs. And I like to teach you how to eat the right carbs that will give you the energy you need, but also the other nutrients.
All right, Doc, now here's the big deal. What's the big difference between your book and any other book out there talking about weight loss and getting your mind right?
Well, there are actually aren't a lot of books that deal with just the mind. And you know I've written a lot of diet books, but a lot of them don't talk about what you need to do. How do you crush the cravings? How do you build a winning environment? How do you boost your confidence? How do you fix your relationship with food? Like now, people are stress eating. So how do you avoid stress eating? So my book addresses very succinctly and very clearly strategies that you can employ right away to start addressing some of those issues.
All right, Dr. Ian Smith, I'll be honest with you. I went to chapter 5 about boosting your confidence, and I was afraid because there was a section that you had in there. I'm like, I might have some problems. It says the signs you lack confidence. And I was going through some of these. I'm like, difficulty accepting compliments from others. You downplay what they say or flat out deny it. I had to check off. Me, socially withdrawn. Unfortunately, I'm a lot of that. Feeling embarrassed or ashamed when you don't achieve perfection. I like to be perfect. A lot of these, I'm like, I have some problems. So here it is. I like to think of myself as accomplished. And then I'm going through your book and I'm like, well, maybe there's a need for me to make myself better in some ways too, and helping myself even build some confidence, because maybe I'm lacking somewhere. I didn't even realize it.
Yeah, you know what? We tend to confuse confidence with what we look like externally. So someone could look confident and walk in a room and dress confidently and carry themselves confidently, but inner-wise, is there real confidence? And that's why on page 136 of the book, it's so important, because like you just recognized, there's some things in here that you're like, wait, hold on for a second, that sounds like me. So this chapter helps you diagnose maybe some underlying issues you weren't aware of, but then it also goes to the next step and says, okay, great. Now let's find some solutions for that. And that's why I love this book so much, and why I think it's a game changer, because it'll allow people to reflect, to analyze, and then write a prescription for a way to win.
Well, I like it because you're obviously not just dealing with the food aspect and the weight loss, you're dealing with the brain and the mind aspect. And I think that's the most important part that gets missed oftentimes, because we'll start something and, as you know, we just don't finish. So I do appreciate that about the book. Now, you know, you've written a lot of books. Do you have, I know you'll say that the new one is your favorite. Do you have any favorites of yours? Because how many books is it now for you? 15 more?
This is 18.
Yeah.
Lucky 18, I say. It's interesting that you asked that. Every book for me has a sentimental attachment.
Yeah.
I write them for different reasons. I write them under different circumstances. I'm inspired by different things. This book is important to me because so many of my followers on social media, by the way, please follow me on social media at Dr. Ian Smith. Spell the doctor out, I-A-N Smith. I give you lots of free tips. There's a 2-week shelter-in-place meal plan on my Instagram page that you can follow. But a lot of my followers on social media and in person, my book readers, have asked me about how do they find their motivation. How do they keep it when things don't look too great? They've had a bad day. How do they get to week 3 and 4 and 5? And so from a personal standpoint, and I've always given people advice, but I've never collated it into one place. And in fact, Pat, I'll tell you, I had to argue with my publisher. I told them I want to write a book that is small, very concise, not big, easy to read, and it's got to be affordable. So you can get it on Amazon or Target or Walmart. It's like $13.99, Barnes & Noble. So I really want people to get the information and make this available to as many people as possible.
Great book. Like I said, chapter 5 kind of shocked me a little bit. I wasn't ready to deal with that truth right there, but I did appreciate it. I encourage anybody or everyone to go get the book. Still one of my favorites, The Truth About Men. If y'all don't got that one, that I always talk to you about that book, man. That book needs to be a movie or something. But hey, we won't talk about that right now. We're dealing with mind overweight. It is good to see you, Doc, looking healthy as ever. Obviously the book is the thing that's going on right now, but what's your next move? Because you always have so much going on. Are you back on TV? You gonna let that go for a while? What's next?
No, I'm just on Good Morning America earlier today, so I'm still doing my TV, but I'm starting a new fiction series, a mystery.
Okay.
It's a private investigator, African-American main character, because there aren't a lot of those in mainstream media, but there's an African-American main character. He's a PI in Chicago. He only takes on select cases around the city. The first one is published this October. It's available now on Amazon.com. It's called The Unspoken. This character is bad, I'm telling you. I love this guy. His name is Ash Kane. So I'm going to be writing him every year for the next several years. And then I got my other novel from last year, The Ancient Nine, just got an option to be a movie or a Netflix series or some kind of series. So we're working on that. So there's a lot going on creatively.
All right. Well, you know, I'm proud of you as always. It's always good to see you when you get back to the H-List hangout for a little while. Tell everybody where they can go and get the book, man, how to follow you once again.
No doubt. The book is everywhere. It's Amazon, Barnes & Noble, Target, Walmart. Order online for fast delivery times. My social media at Dr. Ian Smith. Spell the doctor out. I-A-N Smith on Instagram. On Twitter, it's just Dr. Ian Smith. And my website is drspelledoutiansmith.com. Much love to you, man.
Same to you, Doc. Take care of yourself. Tell the family I say hello, okay, brother?
I will. Be safe.
Yes, sir. You too.